Hello friends, so in this video I'll be helping you with the difference between Fera and Fema Solicitat. So if we talk about the Fera, it is an act promoted to regulate the payment and foreign exchange in India. So it was an act that was introduced or promoted to regulate the payments and the foreign exchange of the India. But if we talk about the Fema, it is an act initiated to facilitate the external trade and payments and to promote the orderly management of forex market in the company. So it was introduced with a motive to maintain the management of the forex market as well as the external trade and payments. Okay, next thing is, if we talk about the act, so Fera was a old act that it was introduced before as compared to your Fema, and Fema is a new act that was introduced in, I guess, 1996. Next thing is, if we talk about the number of sections, so Fera has 81 sections whereas Fema has 49 sections. Okay, next thing, if we talk about when it was introduced, so your Fera was introduced when foreign exchange reserves were low, but if we talk about the Fema, it was introduced when the foreign reserve exchange were satisfactory. Okay, next thing is, if we talk about the basis for determining the residential status. Okay, so for under the Fera Act, the person should have the citizenship, but in the case of Fema, to be considered for determining the residential status, the person should be staying for more than 6 months in India. Okay, next thing is, if we talk about the violation, so violation of Fera Acts comes under criminal offense, but if we talk about the Fema Acts, violation comes under civil offense. And if we talk about the punishment for contravention, so if we talk about the Fera, it is generally imprisonment, but if we talk about the Fema, it is fine or imprisonment. So this was all about the difference between Fera and Fema. So if you like the video, do hit the like button, do consider subscribing, and thanks for watching.